was the couch. I found him difficult, interesting, and a little, like his solution to the Mideast was a little weird.
I mean, his speech the other day was completely crackers, wasn't it? I mean, the irony of him saying they're all on drugs, he looked like he was.
And he wants to call, he thinks the Middle East should come together and be Israelistan.
Well, what do you, I mean, listen, you've interviewed every serious leader in this region going back 30 years. What do you make of what's going on now? What's your overview of it?
I think he may not last. I think this is growing throughout. I think this is spread. Internet started it. I guess it started by Twitter, didn't it?
Mm. One Which guy is extraordinary, getting, right?
Yeah, one guy in Tunisia kills himself. And so the world could change in a day. I wouldn't bet that he lasts. Once the people's revolt start, I think it becomes like a snowball.
When he says that he'll die as a martyr if he needs to, do you believe
he might,
it?
Yeah, he might.
You think he's the kind of character that would?
I don't think he's going to run. Yeah, he would. And he'd see himself going up to heaven with something. I don't think he's going up.
On the scale of all the dictators you've interviewed, where does he rank, do you think, Gaddafi? Because he has a certain notoriety in America for obvious reasons, Lockerbie and other things.
Well, as a dictator, he's among the worst. As an interview, he is the worst. He's not an easy person to talk to, as opposed to, say, Chavez, who is terrific to talk to. Some people are like American. Chavez would be a successful, in my opinion, American politician. He has flair, he has dynamism, he has exuberance. He comes into the room, he changes the room.
Talking of people with flair and dynamism, you've never really revealed your political colors. You've never been able to. You've always felt the powerful thing.
Nobody stopped me. I just felt that I had a role as an interviewer. And my role was, I had simple rules. Leave myself out of it. I never use the word I. Don't give an opinion. I'm a conduit to the audience. Ask short questions. Try to keep a show moving. And be relevant. And be interesting. And be entertaining at the same time. But I thought if I start giving my opinions, and that changed the picture. Now, of course, today now, most shows are opinionated.
Do you feel more able to give opinion now that out of the nightly show?
Not really. No, because I'm going to do other things.
I mean, if I asked you what you thought of Obama and how he's getting on, what would you say?
I would say he had a difficult start. He's getting better. And it doesn't appear that anyone has come forward yet that I would say is going to be a major challenger. Probably the Democrats are hoping they nominate Sarah Palin.
What do you think would happen if they do?
They would win. The Democrats would win.
So Sarah Palin is too polarizing.
And I think she could win the Republican nomination. If there's nine people running, she gets 30%, she wins. But she'd have a America goes to the middle.
Our mutual friend Donald Trump was in a poll yesterday. He came on my show and
said... Where did he finish?
Well, actually, it was interesting. They said if you ran against Obama tomorrow, he would end up 2 points behind him, which was a remarkably close poll. And I think snapped everyone's eyelids back, because when he came in here and said he may well run, the audience I had that day went crazy. I mean, Trump does have a kind of appeal, doesn't he?
But I love Donald, but he does this every election. He's going to run.
You don't believe him?
He did it to me. He had this guy, Roger Stone was his front man to sound out. The reason I don't think Donald will run, as much as I like him and admire him, I don't think he could stand losing.